This is problem number 12 from statics. Here the problem is same as, almost same as problem number 11. Okay. You can see this problem here. There is a vertical wall and this CB, this is a string and AB is a bar, and at the end B, one load is attached. Load is P. Okay. CB, that portion is horizontal, and AB is a straight bar. Okay. The angle is given between the vertical wall and the bar, angle is alpha. Number of string is denoted by 1 and the number of bar is denoted by 2. So here also you have to find out forces induced in the bar and in the string. So it is very clear from the figure that BC, in the string BC, tensile force will be acting, and in the bar AB, compressive force will be acting. Okay, compressive force means this direction, from here it is this direction, and here tensile force will be acting. So if you draw the free body diagram of point B, you take this point and you show the forces, okay, not the spring and the bar, only the forces. So on point B, in the vertically downward direction, the force will be P, and here tensile force is there. So on point B, the tensile force will be in this direction, and since compressive force is acting on the bar AB, so here it will be, the direction will be like this. This is the tension T1. Okay, and here this compression is also denoted by T. This is compressive force, but I am denoting, I am using the same letter T. Okay, but it is compressive force, T2. Right, this angle is given, it is alpha. So here which one will be alpha? With the vertical, na? With the vertical, the angle is alpha. So I am extending the line of action of P, that is the vertical line. So this angle is alpha. Okay, this angle is alpha. And T1 is horizontal. So here, again, if we want to use Lamy's theorem, using Lamy's theorem, we get what? T1 divided by which angle? This one. This one is 180 degree minus alpha. T1 by sine 180 degree minus alpha is equal to T2. By opposite angle is this one, so sine 90 degree is equal to P divided by this angle. This is how much? This is 90 plus alpha. So sine 90 degree plus alpha. So in the next line you write T1 sine 180 degree minus alpha means sine alpha, and it is sine 90 is 1, and P by sine 90 plus alpha is cos alpha. Right, so T1 is P sine alpha by cos alpha, so this becomes P tan alpha. Right, so this is one answer. This is the value of T1. So this is what nature is, tensile force. Okay, and T2, this is equal to P by cos alpha, so it becomes P sec alpha. Okay, nature is compressive. Okay, so these are the answers.